in second spot, and Sean Monroe in third. There we see Biffle come off the corner. He and Monroe are side by side down in turn one. And Biffle's car sticks on the bottom so well. And he gets by Monroe. And there's the slow car where he and Monroe made contact. Now, he closes in on the back bumper of Grosskreutz. Now, Mark thought about going to the inside, but Biffle was there. Goes to the inside. Almost gets by Mark. But now while he's there, he might as well try to take the lead. He's down in the corner. And look at this. Just drives up beside Trimmer. Off the corner in turn one. And Biffle fights on the inside of the racetrack, something that you wouldn't think could be done. But this Tucson Raceway Park with its multiple banks, he can do it, takes the lead as Grosskreutz is trying to take over second spot on the inside.
Now from this point, Greg pretty much pulled away from everybody else, but the next three engaged in a terrific duel to the line.
To the line for second spot. We see John Baker gets loose off the corner. I thought maybe the caution flag was going to wave but be spun. But meanwhile, Mark Grosskreutz is trying it so hard on the inside. He stays there. Monroe closes up. Now they're coming off the corner. This is for the checkered flag. And Monroe and Trimmer make contact and white after the checkered flag. They both spin. But Trimmer goes from leading the race with five laps to go and will finish fourth. And there he is with Bill Weber.
And Carl Trimmer has won a lot of races at this track, a lot of championships. In fact, literally helped build this racetrack. Disappointed here, though, this afternoon.
Well, not really. I think we put on a pretty good show for him. The car got just a little bit tight towards the end there. We put on rears instead of rights. I don't know what we should have did, but maybe next time we'll get smarter. But like I said, when you have to race with people you don't never race against, you don't know how they're going to treat you. Now we know.
Yeah, what do you mean by that, Carl?
Well, you don't know the ones that you can really race with and the ones that will just take you out. You know, the ones that will take you out that I race with every week, I know how to treat them. The ones I never have to race with, you've got to let them knock you around before you know who's going to do what.
There was a lot of traffic there with the four of you cars in the final few laps. I wouldn't have given a chance for anybody passing you on this track, but then there were just so many cars there at one point. Obviously that worked to Biffle's advantage.
Well, yeah, I probably should have kept him behind me, but it was working that good, and I figured he'd probably crash me too, so yes, I let him go.
Well, you have a win here from 2 weeks ago and a fourth place finish today. You are tied for the points with one race to go. I know the victory 2 weeks ago meant a lot to you. Obviously the championship in this Winston Challenge would be another prestigious trophy to add to your mantle.
Yeah, that'd be neat to doing that. It'd be nice.
You're very soft-spoken man, Carl.
Well, what can you do, you know, and you can't cry over spilled milk. I think the car worked great. I was real happy with it. Just towards the end there, it just got a little bit too tight, and I was having to let it drift up a little bit, and they just found a good time to nail you, so there ain't nothing you can do about it.
Thanks for your time. Good luck next time.
Well, thank you.
That's Carl.